guys, welcome to sub-throttles.com. This is Mohit Soni. It's a great day to ride and we've been riding something good, and that is this. This is the Kawasaki Vulcan 650S. We spent an entire day with it. Of it is something what we want to tell you right now. So in terms of styling, as you can see, it looks like a proper cruiser. It's a sort of minimalist in terms of design, because the tank is slightly on the slimmer side with cruisers. There is a saying that the muscularity comes from the tank. It's good enough, but could have been better. But in this role, it looks slightly sportier, so it can get away with that fact. There is a Vulcan S in orange color and green color as well, so that will make the bike look more sporty and pop out as well. There's a lot of things to take in, because despite it's a minimalist design, because everything is exposed, so you can see that side cover, the swing arm, the aftermarket sort of exhaust, but it gels well with the design. There is this chassis ahead of the engine. That's the crankcase in piano black. Those are old school, quite good looking actually, alloy wheels, five spoke design. The disc brake also is quite an old school design. It's not a hollow one, it's more of a solid design. Adds to the cruiser feel, you know. This is the attention to detail that Kawasaki has done. Very motorcycle looking headlight comes from it came from a smaller motorcycle, but yet again very minimalistic, part motorcycle part cruiser in terms of design elements, but it still overall looks like a cruiser, so that should be fine. Let me show you what it offers. It offers adjustable levers on both ends. It's here as well. That is your digital tachometer and analog tachometer and digital speedometer, gear shift indicator, all the fuel efficiency parameters, and telltale lights, and the select button, and the set button, and the for trip meters and odometer. Standard switch gear. That is the hazard light button extra that you get, and this is the same with the engine kill switch and the start stop button. So we've been riding this. What do we think about it? It's a very nice engine. It's the 650cc engine, making 61 PS of power and 63 Newton meters of torque, but the curb weight is quite high. It's at 235 kgs, which actually dampens the power to weight ratio, but in terms of performance. But cruisers are never known for performance, they're known for drivability, and since it's a 650 engine, it will do 120-140 kilometers. It will sustain those speeds at highway if you want to, and it will do it rather well. If you're used to old school cruisers, then you will appreciate this even more. But there are new cruisers from Harley, Indian, and everything, which are on par on this. But Kawasaki 650 mil has always been a gem in terms of drivability, in terms of sound, in terms of character, and in terms of efficiency as well. So you can expect this motorcycle to deliver around, let's say, around 20-25 kilometers to the liter if ridden sanely. The engine is really smooth, the gearbox is smooth, the clutch is extremely light, so driving it in the riding it in the city shouldn't be a problem at all, because it's extremely easy to ride. And no matter how short you are, your legs are going to reach the ground, and the handlebar, if you sat on a Ninja 650, these handlebars are quite similar, but they are even longer, so they come to you to your chest more. But since you sit quite behind, thanks to this seat, it's an extremely comfortable position in any situation, be it touring, weekend rides, or riding in the city. Sorry, excuse the way. The seat, we didn't find it the cushioning quite comfortable. It's quite thin. It may look big and chunky, but this part here isn't doing best for bigger riders, and that pillion seat is almost non-existent. in terms of dynamics, it's actually quite easy to chuck around in the city. It's extremely nimble. You can go through traffic without realizing this is a big bike or a big cruiser. It's extremely easy to ride because it turns in quickly, and it's a very nimble motorcycle in the city, in short. And it's quite agile in the corners, very stable, but it can upset a bit in the mid corner because the suspension is quite stiff and almost on the harsh side. So it is done because this cruiser has only 130 mm of ground clearance, so it can bottom out with heavy riders. I am a heavy rider, but I didn't scrape it down on the biggest speed breakers here in Pune and Bombay. So that's the reason why the suspension is stiff. We recommend you keep it that way so that you don't bottom it out if you are a heavy rider. Lighter riders will also need to keep the suspension at a preload rear suspension at a level where it doesn't bottom out, which is best for the exhaust canister and that is mounted below, which will be the first thing that will the speed breakers will hit. The brakes are decent, could have been better, but for a cruiser we can't complain. It does the job really well. I think that's about it. That is about it for the motorcycle. It's quite good. It does what it does efficiently and smoothly and easily. There's a lot of comfort on offer, be it any type of riding situation. What is also the best part of the Vulcan is the pricing. It retails around 6.5 lakhs in most cities, slightly lower than that as well. So this makes it quite a good price for money. And given the fact that this engine is now regarded as bomb-proof, it's extremely reliable. It's never gone. It's never gone bust, or we haven't heard horror stories about this 650cc engine, or with any other Kawasaki engine as well. So this engine is quite flexible. This is almost the fourth motorcycle that Kawasaki is using this engine with. A little bit of changes done to make sure low end torque and mid range is powerful enough. There isn't hardcore top end, but you don't need that on the motorcycle like this. So coming to the fact that the engine is reliable and the pricing is right, it does everything extremely well. It is an entry level cruiser, it's not a 1000cc cruiser. So the pricing is right, it's comfortable enough, it does the job well, it's extremely smooth. And if you are looking for a Japanese cruiser, then this is the only option you have in this segment. You'll have to wait when their Kawasaki's competition replies, because there aren't any available in the international markets as well, as far as we know. So that is what sums up the Vulcan S here. So thank you so much for tuning in, guys. If you appreciate what we do, hit that like button and also subscribe to the channel, because we'll be bringing up more motorcycle and car reviews in Hindi and English.